I'm pushed to bump a friend with lips touching each other, making everybody immediately laugh, but those students still want to tease me. While I fall asleep in the class, they put two of us next to each other. The next day, this fat boy comes to tell me that, "Congratulations, you're about to be a father." Yesterday, I watched a movie that the main actor and actress kissed then slept together. And then her tummy grew big. "Granny, where do babies come from?" she says, kicked from the rubbish dump. "You'll know when you grow up. I can just only ask my teacher," which surprises her. Then she explains, but I still don't get it. Her expression suddenly changes. "You'll learn this next year." The girl, Xiao 11, wishes not to be pregnant. At that same moment, I hear that no pineapples for pregnant women. So I use my savings to buy tons of pineapples. Xiao 11 keeps eating for hours, resulting in her bringing to a clinic. Our parents both come to the clinic to solve this. When I come back home, I'm scolded by my parents, just "Granny protects me." But I'm still punished to go face the wall. My parents start blaming each other for not teaching me properly. My brother, Tom, who is eavesdropping, hopes that they will divorce. This is my family. Tom has got a prize for writing blogs. But my mom, who is a magazine editor, says that he does not work properly. On Father's Day, Tom gives Daddy a shaver. But my mom yells at him, "What waste of money." Good wishes have turned into scolding. It's wrong for children to play with their phones while eating. But it's okay for adults to do so. My mom will never stop nagging. We gradually get used to this. But what makes it even harder for us to accept is the school. One day, the school is conducting phone checks. The teacher just needs to make a call. The student has to take the phone out of her pocket to give it to him. The next student even puts it in his pants. But Tom accidentally drops a pornographic VCD. The teacher is dumbfounded. Tom immediately kicks it away, and then his friends also do the same thing. The teacher is being teased to turn around and around, but in the end, he has caught it. After that, Tom's best friend, Ching Kai, quickly protects him. The teacher is pissed off and wants to hit him. While the students who did not surrender the phones yet take videos of the scuffle, Tom immediately comes to separate them. This is extremely serious. The parents are invited to the school. Finally, the principal decides to expel Ching Kai due to multiple disciplinary records. After going home, he is even beaten by his parents. While Tom is subjected to public caning for his part in the scuffle, he is punished hard by the teacher with a whip. Each whip is killing his pride. But my mom thinks that it's not wrong to punish students in public like that, because she cares about her honor. About the principal, she wants the students to feel shame in front of their friends, so that next time when they commit this offense, they'll think twice. Nobody considers their feelings. Tom and Cheng Kai are both extremely disappointed in their parents and school. Not long after, they both join a group of gang. At least, they can find it happy here. No matter how much my dad hits Tom, he wouldn't be able to get better. Today, the gangsters tell them to steal things. As a result, they are not only beaten to the ground, but also asked for $2,000. Or he has to go to jail. Tom needs the money so much that he steals my piggy bank. Even though this money is very important to me, I still give it to him. But he has no idea that I also stole it. Furthermore, my parents shortly learn about my theft. They ask me where is the money, and assume that I stole the money for Pokemon cards. They even hit me hard with the whip. Now I can only admit that I just wanted to buy 1 hour of your time to attend my concert. They are always busy with work. I wanted to pay with my savings, but it's not enough, so stealing was my last way. After knowing that, they are speechless. They didn't know that they always don't understand how to teach their children. Shortly later, they go to visit Tom's room. And then see his paper notes and blog posts about how much he has been struggling. Not only that, but it also includes his disappointment with our parents and school. At that time, Tom and Ching Kai desperately go to steal a necklace from an elderly. But after acknowledging their misdeeds, they go to return it. But the other residents go to apprehend them. Tom's phone drops while he is running away, activating a speed dial on my dad. He immediately rushes off without caring about the meeting when he sees Tom is being beaten. The boss keeps chasing him, but it's useless. At that point, Ching Kai's dad is passing by. So he quickly goes to protect Ching Kai from the fight. But he ends up being knocked unconscious. My granny and mom also come to defend Tom's action for stealing, explaining that they have failed their responsibilities as parents. "Look at the state my son is in today, it's proof of our mistake." Seeing the police come, my dad kneels on the ground. He even tells the police that he is the robber. Luckily, the grandma says that she made a prank call to the police station. Before leaving, she looks at him and says, "You must listen to your father." On the other side, Ching Kai's father is hospitalized in a critical state. Before he dies, Ching Kai invites the principal over. The principal even lies to his dad that he has been accepted by the school. But his dad immediately exposes it. In his last words, he encourages Ching Kai to aim for the top to prove his worth. He has failed to teach his son as a father. He didn't even know how to love. After his father's death, the principal lets Ching Kai return to school. Ching Kai can come back to school and practice for his passion for martial arts. Eventually, he becomes a world champion in an international fighting tournament. Mom and Dad finally make it to my concert. From now on, my dad and mom have realized how to love me and my brother. All children can be taught. It's how the parents and teachers teach them. They often use the name of love to do things that may hurt children's feelings. Children are not stupid. They just need encouragement and compliments. Somehow along the way, praises and encouragement change as they grow up. Therefore, don't easily criticize them on their work by not looking at the merits.